Guys, hope you're doing good. So today in this video I will be sharing my DevOps engineer resume. So this resume helped me to fetch a couple of job offers and I was able to crack those interviews, and actually I got those interview calls from this resume only. So I will be sharing my resume with you guys. So let's start. So every resume, like my resume also, it starts with my name. So you can write your name in the bold letter so that it is visible to the recruiter. So that is a good practice that you can follow on the top. Okay, and then you can include your professional experience like I have included in my resume. So in your professional experience, you need to list down all the companies in which you have worked in the reverse chronological order. So let's suppose you are working in a particular ABC company currently, and in the past you have worked with XYZ company. So your latest company or your current company will come on the top, and your past and previous companies will go down in the bottom part. Okay, so this way you have to list down your companies. So likewise, I have listed down my company ABC Solutions. I have hidden my company name, and and then you need to enter your location in which you were working. So I was working in Noida, Uttar Pradesh, India. So I mentioned that location, and then comes your designation. My designation was DevOps Specialist, so I mentioned that. You can mention your own designation. And just one more disclaimer before we proceed ahead. So no need to copy this resume entirely, just you can take an idea from this video, okay, and then you can make your own resume. Now so next, after designation, you can mention the time period from which you were working. So only month and year is enough, no need to mention the date. Okay, and then your project name, this is optional. I have written my project name. You can make your choice. If you want to write project name, you can write that, and be ready to explain your project in the interview. Now comes the important part, main part. This is the main part of your resume. This actually decides whether you will get interview call or not. Okay, so I was working in Azure and I was maintaining IaaS and PaaS services, and I was experienced like approximately 3 years. So I mentioned this. And make sure you include bullet points in your resume. No need to make paragraphs in your resume. Add bullet points, and that bullet points can be one liner or two liner bullet points. Okay, and likewise, I have included having 3 years of experience in managing Azure infrastructure, is IaaS and PaaS services. So you can mention like that. And then I have worked on Azure DevOps. You are using basically Azure DevOps for a build and Octopus Deploy for a deployment. So I have mentioned the same in my resume, as you can see, using Azure DevOps for code build and Octopus Deploy for deployment. And next comes, you are using Terraform actually for infrastructure provisioning. So I mentioned the same, as you can see, simple language I have mentioned, not complex language. Okay, simple, using Terraform for automating infrastructure provisioning. So likewise, you can also mention. And next, similarly, I mentioned all the other tech stacks on which I was working, like containerizing applications using Docker and ensuring successful deployments on Kubernetes clusters. So similarly, you can make your list down your skills, and then you can make these one liner bullet points out of your skills, because everyone's skills are different. Okay, so this is how I have mentioned my skills, roles and responsibilities, you can say. Okay, and then I have mentioned my first company name. I have actually hidden the name, XYZ Solutions. Again, location will come, and then the job designation and time period from which you have worked. I worked from 2018 to 2020. Again, your project name you can mention, it's optional, it's not mandatory. And again, the same list and the bullet points will come. You can write your own bullet points, like I have written, experience in managing Azure infrastructure, collaborating with development teams of code build and deployment, writing PowerShell to automate manual task optimizing and building pipelines. So this way you can list down your skills and then your responsibilities according to those skills. Okay, and make sure you prepare your resume only in one page. Your resume should be limited to one page only. No need to have two pages of resume. One page is the best. And make sure the second thing is bullet points. Use bullet points. Okay, and now let's move on to the contact part, which is very important, because this is from these details only recruiter will contact you. I have mentioned my phone number and my email ID. Make sure to have a proper email ID, not a funky Gmail ID that some people use. Proper professional email ID, and then your phone number. And this is the optional part which I have included. You can include your own GitHub links I have included. If you have any GitHub profile, you can include that. If you have a LinkedIn profile, you can include that. I have written some blogs, so I have included that. So this is the optional part. This will vary depending on the person. And now next comes the skills. Again, this will vary. I have mentioned my own skills which I am having: AWS, Azure, PowerShell, Azure DevOps, Jenkins, Terraform. So all these tech stacks I have worked upon. So I have listed down. And next comes the education part which I have listed. In my education, I have like started with my BTech Electrical Engineering, and 2018 pass out. And the percentage I have mentioned. Similarly, 12th I have completed in 2013 and 10th. So, and the percentage I have listed down, okay. So you can mention your education part accordingly. And then is the certification. I have done AZ 900 and now I have done AZ 104, so I will list that down. And you can mention your own certifications. If you don't have any certification, just skip this section, okay. No need to write a certification if you don't have. So this is how like I have prepared my resume, and this resume really helped me to get interview calls. And similarly, you can prepare your own. Your template can vary. No need to follow and copy this template. You can definitely go to Google Docs, go to MS Word. There are a lot of templates that you can follow. If you want to have a video on that as well, I will create a video. Just let me know in the comment section. Okay. And yeah, so this is it. This was my resume. This was a professional experience on the left hand side, and then the contact, skills, education on the right hand side. So I hope this video will really help those guys who are like struggling to build their resume. So yeah, that's it guys for this video, and thank you for watching. Bye bye.